work. I think you're onto something.
This next song is a song I wrote during the COVID. What?
Is it during the Great Pause?
Yeah, the Great Pause. A lot of it, but I mean, you brought this up several times about how you kind of like it better.
During the unraveling?
The unraveling. You were happy to be home all of
that. I was pleasantly surprised how much I liked being away from you.
Were you really surprised?
I mean, look, I've spent more time with you than pretty much most of the human beings that I know. And it comes with a certain degree of comfort. And then to just have you gone.
Gotta keep everything in the shadow.
See, I've been seeing
you more comfortable.
It doesn't bring me much comfort at all. You don't want me in here.
No, it's like this is close enough. Like the 6-4 perimeter is a good thing. I was just saying,
I got you.
We had come home from a tour, and it's funny, I was listening to a podcast, and there were other people that are actors and producers, and they were kind of talking about the same thing, that there's kind of something always on the calendar, there's always something on the horizon. So even when we would come home from work, there was always something else, there was always other work to look forward to, and then often there are multiple projects, and they all overlap with one another, so we would have, you know, an upcoming, say, a Halloween show, and so we're working on that stuff, or you have an upcoming tour or other side projects. There's always music and always things you're working on, not to mention all of the stuff you're working on at home in the meantime. And this time we came home, and there were none of those things. So it took a long while, it's 30 years of doing that, of sort of being in that mode. And it took a while just to sort of get used to just being sedentary and being in one place and really like committing to that. And it felt amazing. It was great.
It's nice to have stuff on the calendar that you're actually looking forward to, though. I'm just thinking of those things.
Are you on LinkedIn now? What's going on?
I miss your OnlyFans.
Rob's looking for bitches.
I'm just thinking it could be worse. It could be like, you could hate your job.
That's true.
You got every day on the calendar for the rest of your life.
Right? That's true.
Here we go.
So this is a song that Rob wrote during that time frame.
I started doing a thing where I was writing songs for people, and some of them were a little weird. Like, you know, there was one I wrote about a line at a bagel shop, which was, you know, it was hard to figure out like how that's gonna relate to everybody. But everything I did sort of would come up with these ideas and I guess I would get you know, whoever I was writing for to, you know, tell me a little bit about why, you know, what's it for and stuff. And then I would just sort of put my own take on, like, the words, you know. They didn't write the lyrics, but they, you know, in their letter they wrote to me, you know, I would pick the stuff out that kind of jumped out. This next song is called Ups and Downs, and that one was, you know, it was from a line that this woman had wrote about her husband and their life together, how much she loved them, but they've had their ups and downs and stuff. And from there I went on, and that sort of related my own experiences with my own relationships. Thank you.
Into the future.
Silky, crazy night.
No good comes from me interrupting you in the middle of the story, so...
This is good. This is wonderful. We can just do this all night long.
You can finish what you're saying if you like or not.
Thank you.
school night.
Yeah. Thank you. Double encore. Stitching, yeah. That was great.
Crushing.
We've got two more shows this weekend, and that's gonna wrap up the mostly acoustic tour for now.
For now.
We've been having a good time doing this.
For now.
Yes. But it won't be long. Less than a couple of weeks before you get back out on the road with Moe again.
I can't wait for this Sinclair!
That's it. 2 weeks from tonight. That's it.
What about the Blue Mill Project?
That's right. And then 2 weeks after that, probably be back out on the road again with Vinny, and Tim Palmieri, and Nate Wilson.
Yeah!
Blue Star Radiation.
What are you going to do?
Is that Blue Star Radiation? Is that what it is?
Blue Star Radiation.
That's it.
Is that what you said?
Yeah, I was just making sure I had it right.
Yeah, it's a Blue Mill Project, man. How do you feel about Sweetwater?
Yeah, they're on there. Sweetwater,
you're on the first day.
Oh, yeah.
Workout. How about the Sinclair? I can't wait for the Sinclair.
That's about half a year from now.
Yeah, it's like a half a year from now. 1,500 miles from here. But yes, we are playing in Atlanta in April. So, guys, gonna be there.
Just in red, that old cocaine going straight to my head. Cocaine running all around my brain. Hey, pretty mama, dressed in white. Old cocaine keep me up all night. Cocaine running all around my brain. Thank you. They pretty mama, all dressed in blue. That old cocaine is gonna see me through. Cocaine running all around my brain. Hey pretty mama, dressed in green. That old cocaine like nothing I've ever seen. Cocaine running all around my brain.
Yeah.
so much. We appreciate it. What fun we had. Thank you for coming out for this. Give it up for Al Schnier. Yeah.
Give it up for Rob Derhak.
Thank you.
Thank you, folks. Have a great night.
Hey, Al, can I have the set list? Al, can I get Rob?
Thank you for coming to the west side of Massachusetts. Thank you.